Hello friends, the topic for today is PIC 18 resets. The PIC family of devices such as the 2455, 2550, 4455 and 4550 differentiate various kinds of resets such as power on reset POR, then MCLR reset, then watchdog timer reset, programmable brownout reset BOR, then reset instruction, then stack full reset and stack underflow reset. These are the various kinds of resets. In today's video, you will learn the PIC 18 resets. Let us start. Welcome to our channel Engineering and Technology for You. If you are not subscribed to our channel, kindly subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications about future videos. The topic for today is PIC 18 resets. Let us start with the introduction. The PIC microcontroller, when resets signal is activated, the MCU microcontroller unit goes into the reset state, during which initial conditions are established. And when the MCU comes out of the reset state, its program counter is cleared to 00000, which is called as the reset vector. Now, after the reset, the MCU begins the execution of instruction from location 00000H. The PIC microcontrollers, they have the various kinds of resets: power on reset, MCLR reset during normal operation, then MCLR reset during power managed modes, then watchdog timer or WT reset during the execution, then programmable brownout reset, that is BOR, then reset instruction, stack full reset and stack underflow resets. So these are the various kinds of resets which it can differentiate. Let us see the resets one by one. And before that, we'll see the reset control register and the block diagram. So here you can see the reset circuit for the PIC controller. Here we have, these are the pins VDD, MCLR bar and OSC1. These are the external pins. And then we have the reset instruction reset, then stack pointer full or underflow reset, and then we have the reset by the MCLR, that is external reset, and here there is the MCR clear enable. Then we have the idle or sleep. So these two, again, they are taken into the reset. Then watchdog timer out, timeout, that is one input. Then VDD rise detect and brownout reset. So these are concerned with the brownout reset BOR. So here we have the BOR enable signal, and this is the power on reset pulse. So all these are combined and then given to the input of a SR flip-flop, and the to the S input of the SR flip-flop, and to the R pin of SR flip-flop, the other, the oscillator PWRT, there is the resistors. There, here we have the counter, 11 bit triple counter, and this is 10 bit triple counter and 11 bit triple counter, and they are given as input to the R input of this, and that will generate the chip's reset. So that is active low. So these are the enablers of the PWRT and OST oscillator. So we'll have the discussion in details. First, the Archon resistor. So the device reset events are tracked through the Archon or reset control resistor. The lower 5 bits of the reset indicate that a specific reset event has occurred. And in most of the cases, these bits can be cleared by the event and must be set by the application after the event, so that for the next reset, it will be useful. Then the state of these flag bits taken together can be read to indicate the type of reset that just occurred. So each of these are having flag bits. So the flag bits will be either 0 or 1. And depending on that, we can know the type of reset which has occurred. Then the Archon resistor also has a control bits for setting the interrupt priority and software control of the BOR, that is SBORN, that is the BOR enable signal. So that is possible to have the enable the BOR signal with the help of software. Then let us go to the next details of the Archon. So here it's a 8-bit resistor. Here the bit 7, that is IPEN, that is interrupt priority enable bit, that is used for the interrupts. So one means it will enable the interrupt priority levels on the interrupt, and this 0 means it will disable the priority levels on the interrupt. So this bit is here for the interrupt priority. Then bit 6, that is SBORN, that is BOR software enable bit. So this bit, if it is 1, BOR is enabled. If it is 0, BOR is disabled. And here the BOREN 1 and BOREN 0, these two are the configuration bits. So that should, if it is 01, then only this will occur. Otherwise it is unavailable. Then for if these bits 00, 10 and 11, in this case bit is disabled and read as 0. So only when this two bits, configuration bits, they are 01, it can be enabled or disabled. Then bit 5 is unimplemented. Then bit 4, that is the RI bit, reset instruction flag bit. So this will be used for the reset instruction. If it is 1, then reset instruction was not executed, that is it was not executed. If it is 0, if it is clear, then only the reset instruction was executed, causing the device reset. So this is an indication that the reset is due to the reset instruction. So it will be cleared in this case. Then let us see the next bit, that is bit 3. So that is T0 bar was the timer out bit. So this bit, so it is active low. So if it is 0, it means that a watchdog timeout has occurred. This watchdog timer is generally used for software debug, and it will be, the timer will be set for instructions. So whenever it overflows or it is time out, then the reset will occur, and this bit 0, it will be set to 0. So this will indicate that the reset has occurred because of the watchdog timer. And if it is 1, that means it is set by power up or the clear watchdog timers CLRWT instruction or sleep instruction. So these two instructions will make it one. And if it is zero, that means the watchdog timeout has occurred and that will reset the MCU. Then bit 2, there is power down detection flag bit, PD bar. Again it is active low. So if it is zero, set by execution of the sleep instruction. So this is for the when we go to the sleep mode or power down mode. So it will become zero. And when it is one, that is again set by the same power up or CLRWT instruction. Then bit 1, that is for the power on reset status, POR bar, power on resets. So it is again active low. So when it is 0, that means a power on reset occurred. And if it is 1, then a power on reset has not occurred. Then bit 0, it is for the power on reset status bit, BOR bar. Again, it is active low. So when it is 0, it means that power on reset has occurred. And if it is 1, that means it has not occurred. So it will just give the status. So this is about the Archon register. Let us see the first master clear reset. So the MCLR pin provides a method for triggering an external reset of the device. So this is a pin which can reset the device. So the reset is generated by holding the pin low. So it is active low, MCLR bar. So we have to hold it low to reset the MCU. The devices have a noise filter in the MCLR reset path which detects and ignores small pulses. So this is just to avoid reset with small pulses. So that's why the noise filters are required, so that the first reset is not done. Then the MCLR pin is not driven low by any internal resets, such as including the watchdog timer. We have the internal resets, so this pin will not be driven low by that. It is only with the help of external we can make it low. Then the devices, PIC devices, all these four devices, the MCLR input can be disabled with this MCLRE configuration bit. So this is a configuration bit in the configuration register. So we can disable this bit, and when it is disabled, that will become a digital input. So it will not act as a reset pin then. Then let us see the external manual reset. Here a push button key is connected to MCLR pin, that is master clear pin, to a resistor divide. So you can see this is the resistor divide, 47 kilo ohms and 47 ohms. And this is the VDD, that is plus 5 volt. And this is the key connected here. So this is connected to the MCLR bar pin. So when the key is pushed, the MCLR is grounded. So the current will flow in this way, and this will become, it will be grounded. So it will reset the MCU. Then let us go to the next, power on reset. The power on reset pulse is generated on chip whenever VDD rises above certain threshold. This allows the device to start in the initialized state when VDD is adequate for operation. So here the voltage VDD, there is the supply voltage, whenever we switch on the power, it will rise and above certain threshold. On this threshold, generally it will be taken above certain value, so that the initiation stage it occurs and it is sufficient for the operation. If it is below that threshold, then we'll have to reset the MCU. Generally this voltage is 4.2 volts. So to take the advantage of pure circuitry, we have to make use of the MCLR pin. So here we are using 1k and 210 k ohms resistor, and that is connected to the VDD. So there is no need of external RC component generally required for the power on reset. So we can have it, but internally there is provision. Then for a slow time, we can see the figure 2, which is on the next slide. So the PUR events are captured by the PUR bit, that is RCON bit 1. So the state of the bit sets to 0 whenever PUR occurs. So it is active low. So whenever power on reset occurs, this bit will be set to 0. It does not change for any other reset event. So it is exclusively for the PUR event. So PUR is not reset to 1 by any hardware event. So to capture multiple events, the user manually resets the bit to 1 in the software following the PUR. So we'll have to set it to 1 manually in order to capture multiple events. Then let us see the figure here, external power on reset. So the external power on reset is required only if the VDD power slope is too slow. So diode D helps to discharge the capacitor quickly when the VDD power downs. This is for the discharge of the when it is down. So here when we connect this R and C, and there is one more R1 is connected. So generally this R is less than 40 kilo ohms and R1 is greater than 1 kilo ohm. So that will be for limiting the current into the MCLR pin from this capacitor. So whenever this is slow, at that time we'll have to take care that we connect the diode here and these two resistances and a capacitor, so that the discharge, whenever it is down, then it will discharge immediately through the diode. So in this way we can for slow VDD power up, we can use this. Then watchdog timer reset. So the timer resets the microcontroller when the timer runs out of time, that is, or it overflows, and clears bit 3. So bit B3, that is T0 bar bit in RCON resistor. So the timer is used to detect software bugs. So when a set of instructions take much longer time than expected, so this timer will be set. And if it is runs out of time or it overflows, then that means the instructions, they are actually caught in a infinite loop. So this timer will reset the MCU microcontroller, and the source of the reset can be identified by checking the bit B3 in RCON resistor. So this bit, we can, it will be, if it is 0, that means it is set by the watchdog timer. then brownout reset BUR. So here the device is 2455 2555 and 4455 and 4550. These four devices we are considering. They implement BUR circuit that provides user with a number of configurations and power saving options. So if the supply voltage VDD it falls below a certain limit, so generally this BVDD, that is brownout voltage, so that is generally 4.2 volts for a 5 volt supply. So the microcontroller will not function properly in that case. So the BOR resets the MCU and clears the bit B0, that is BOR bar in the RCON register. Already we have seen this, and the MCU will stay in the reset state. So when VDD rises above BVDD, there is 4.2 volts, and if the power up timer PWRT, power up timer, we have seen this, the diagram, block diagram, is enabled, the MCU goes to the reset vector and after a delay provided by PWRT, so it will go to the reset vector. So reset vector means 0000, 5 times 0, and once it goes there, that means then the execution will start from that address. So the BOR can be enabled or disabled by the specified bits in the configuration register. So we can enable or disable the BOR also. So this, which bits we are going to do, that is, so this BOR configurations, so it is controlled by this BOR V1 and BOR V0 and BOREN1 and BOREN0, these bits. So if it is 00, it is unavailable, so BOR is disabled. Then if it is 01, this case it is available. So that is what we are seeing. So BOR is enabled in software and operation controlled by SBOREN bit. So this should be 01 configuration bit, these two configuration bits, they should be 01 for making the BOR available. So if it is available, then only we can use it. Then 10 and 11, again it is unavailable. So these are the BOR configurations. Then let us go to the next, that is reset instruction and stack reset. The PIC 18 instruction set includes reset instruction that resets the MCU. So with the help of software also we can reset the MCU. So this is software equivalent of hardware resetting MCLR. So when this instruction is executed, bit 4, that is RI, reset instruction in RCON register, you have seen this, so it will be cleared. So when we make this, it will clear this bit. So when we are giving the reset instruction, it will clear this bit. So it means that the reset has occurred because of the reset instruction. Then the last is stack full and underflow reset. So when stack overflows, when it is full, it will overflow, or it underflows, the MCU is reset. So this is the last type of reset the PIC 18 can detect. So with this we come to the end of this video. If you have any questions, you can contact me on Facebook, Twitter, Gmail or Instagram. Then if you like the video, press the like button, share with your friends and subscribe to our channel Engineering and Technology for You. And don't forget to press the bell icon for getting notifications about future videos. And thanks for watching. Have a nice day.